Dear viewers, I'm proud to tell you that my brother, Father Joseph Abraham, was a giant, a legend of a person, a great man of faith, a man who loved his people. Father Joseph Abraham was so devoted to the Lord, to the Holy Eucharist and the Mother of Jesus, who was his mother, Mother Mary. On this day when we have laid him to rest in this tomb, we believe in the words of Jesus, "Everyone who believes in me, even though he dies, will live forever." This is the faith that keeps us going. This is the faith of every Christian, and this is the hope of every human being, that even after we die, we will live forever in the presence of God. Father Joseph was an extraordinary person who loved young and great, who loved the rich and the poor, who loved the abandoned and all those who came to him seeking for any kind of help. We are proud that God gave us such a human being. And as once upon a time, Mark Tully said when Mahatma Gandhiji died, "Future generations will not believe that such a person in flesh and blood ever walked upon the face of this earth." I would want to tell those very same words. Future generations will not believe that such a holy, a gentle, a pious, a loving, a faithful priest walked upon the face of this earth in this generation. He is one whom we have to learn to emulate. Emulate in our lives, in a life full of faith, of hope, and truly a life of love. Love the poor. And as was told in the funeral mass, Father wanted all the people to love the poor people, wanted all the people to have great faith in Jesus in all the times of their life, at any moment of their life, especially in the moments of pain and difficulty. Father Joseph is a great icon of faith and love to us. May God, who has called him to his heavenly home, grant him eternal peace and rest in his kingdom. And may Mary, our mother, whom he loved so tenderly, keep him in her arms for all eternity. And may Father Joseph Abraham pray for all of us. And for all of you viewers, God bless you.
friends, we know Reverend Father Joseph Abraham was a very dynamic priest and had a great devotion to the most sacred heart of Jesus and also to Mother Mary. He promoted these two devotions in the Archdiocese of Bangalore and outside the Archdiocese of Bangalore. As a priest, he dedicated his life to promote the devotion to the Holy Eucharist. He spent many hours before the Blessed Sacrament and also hearing confessions. It is indeed a great loss to the Archdiocese and also the Church in India. My dear friends, on occasion like this, we need to realize that our life on earth is not eternal. Sooner or later, we need to pass through this life. Therefore, let us try to dedicate our life for the greater glory of God and for the welfare of others. Someone has said, we are afraid to die because we are afraid to live. If we are not afraid to live, we'll never be afraid to die. Therefore, let us love God and our neighbor and commit our lives to the glory of God and for the welfare of our brothers and sisters. May the soul of Reverend Father Joseph Abraham rest in peace. Amen.
பிரியமான சகோதர சகோதரிகளே, இன்று பெங்களூர் மறை மாவட்டத்தில் முதன்மை குருவாகவும் பல அன்னை பசிலிக்க ஆலயத்தில் தலைமை குருவாகவும் பணியாற்றி நம்மை விட்டு சென்றிருக்கின்ற தந்தைய ஜோசப் மரியர் ஏப்ராம் ராயன் அவர்கள் காலமான நாளை இன்று நாம் நினைவு கூறுகின்றோம். துக்கத்தோடு அவர் நம்முடைய பெங்களூர் மெட்ராசனத்து பல ஆலயங்களில் பங்கு தந்தையாக இருந்து பல அரும்பு காரியங்களை செய்திருக்கின்றார். சமீபத்தில் அன்னை பசிலிக்க ஆலயத்தில் பங்கு குருவாகவும் மற்றும் முதன்மை குருவாகவும் பல பணிகளை செய்து இன்று இறைவன் அவரை தம்மிடம் அழைத்திருக்கின்றார். அவருடைய மறைவு நமக்கு சோகத்தையும் துக்கத்தையும் கொடுத்தாலும் கூட நமக்கு ஒரு ஆறுதல். அவருடைய வாழ்ந்த வாழ்க்கை, அன்னை கன்னிமரியாள் மீது வைத்திருந்த பக்தியும், அன்னை ஆண்டவர் இயேசு கிறிஸ்து மீது நற்கரன் மீது வைத்திருந்த பக்தியும், அவர் நிச்சயமாக இறைவனுடைய சன்னிதானத்தில் நித்திய பிறப்பத்துக்கு அவரை தகுதியுடையவராக ஏற்றுக்கொள்வார் என்ற நம்பிக்கையோடு மறைந்த தந்தை ஜோசப் மரிய ராயன் ஏப்ராம் அவருடைய ஆன்மலைப்பாட்டுக்காக தொடர்ந்து ஜெபிப்போம். அவருடைய வெற்றி சென்ற பணிகளை நாம் தொடர்ந்து நிறைவேற்ற இறைவன் அவரையும் அவர் குடும்பத்தை சார்ந்தவர்களையும் விசேஷமாக ஆசீர்வதித்து அவருக்கு நித்திய பெருமத்து பங்களிக்க வேண்டும் என்று ஜெபிப்போமாக. நித்திய ஏற்பாட்டை ஆண்டவரே என்று கழித்திருடும் முடிவில்லாத ஒளி விரும்பது என்று ஒளிவதாக. ஆமென்.
ரெவரன் ஃபாதர் ஜோசப் ஏப்ராம், a pastor, a preacher, a great devotee of Sacred Heart and Mother Mary, passed away and he has entered into eternal life. Father Joseph Abraham lived 69 years and 43 years he spent as a priest of the Archdiocese of Bangalore. He loved people, he loved God. He was a tireless preacher of the word of God and he went in search of the strayed sheep. He gathered thousands and thousands of souls for the Lord. Today, this funeral is a mega funeral in the history of the Archdiocese and is a perfect tribute paid to the priest of God. May his soul rest in peace. May he pray for all of us from heaven so that one day we also may follow and enter into New Jerusalem, our home where God awaits for us. Father Joseph Abraham, may God give you eternal rest and peace. Thank you for all the services that you rendered to this archdiocese, very especially being a model priest, a model Christian, a beautiful disciple of the Lord. God bless. May your soul rest in peace. Amen.
My eldest brother, Father Joseph Abraham, who I have seen from the day I have been born, is a brother who really loved the Eucharist. He has never in his whole life ever missed going for Mass every single day or saying Mass every single day. To just put in perspective, the last 1.5 years that he has not been well, he has said Mass every day at his bedside. Every day he used to hold the Eucharist close to his chest and always feel comforted and feel happy. I feel so proud of having a brother like that, who had so much of trust in God, who had so much of trust in Jesus, and always showed the whole family that Jesus is the only way to heaven. I really would miss my brother, but I'm sure he has touched the lives of hundreds and thousands, I can say millions of people across the world. He's traveled to the Americas, he has traveled to Europe, he has traveled to the Middle East, across India, preaching the good news. And that is what he was sent for, preaching the good news. And I'm sure Jesus would be today holding him in his arms and saying, well done, my true and faithful servant. Hats off to you, Father, and keep us always in your prayers, and keep my family always in your prayers. Thank you.
Very privileged to have Father Joseph Abraham as a brother, as a member of a family. In fact, it is a gift of God. God has lent him to us, and we are fortunate to have him. And God now, after he has finished his work, has now taken him back to himself. He was a very humble person. He sought nothing for himself, lived a very simple life, had very few needs, but he had a great desire to make Jesus known. In fact, the theme of his ordination, the mission, was to proclaim the word, and that he done in season and out of season. He done it every day. He was faithful to the church and its teachings. He was faithful to the bishop, an obedient and loyal servant of the church. May God grant him eternal rest. He will continue to do his work in heaven by working on earth. He will also intercede for us with Jesus, our Savior. He was greatly devoted to the divine mercy, the mercy of God. We know that the mercy of God is far more than his justice. Its mercy comes only when there is justice. God loves. God has a big heart. God is very generous. And that is what he done. He proclaimed this generosity and mercy to everyone around. May God grant him eternal rest, a place in the heavenly court. May God be merciful to him. May he always be with the angels and saints in paradise, singing the praises of God. Thank you very much.
About my brother, he was closest to me since I was next to him. And the thing that impressed me most was his love for the Eucharist, for the Holy Mass. Anywhere, wherever on earth he was, and he has widely traveled all over the world, he would not wish to miss a Mass on a day. And if many Masses are possible, like Mary's Feast and all the other feasts, he would be saying even a dozen Masses. He would be sitting there from morning to night, concelebrating with every priest that is around, the love for the Eucharist. And that is why the chalice and the paten was on his body, kept all through during the Mass that he had. The second was for the love of Mary. His name was named after Mary, and he loved Mary all through. Every possible titles of Mary he has honored. He has visited as far as possible. And like the bishop said, any little time that he gets, he would be in Velangani. He would have gone to Pundi. He has been to Lourdes. He has been to Fatima. He has been to so many shrines. And he spread the love of Mary. In the Archdiocese of Bangalore, he is the one who started the Hail Mary at the end of the Mass, after the communion. Three Hail Marys, and which is a practice and becoming a tradition to be followed by everybody, and everyone voluntarily does follow. So these two things are what impressed me, being a brother of him, that I say his love for the Mass and the Eucharist and his devotion to Mother Mary. I hope these things are all followed by the people. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. I feel so blessed having had such a wonderful priestly holy brother in my eldest brother, Father Joseph Abraham, who has returned to God, who lived a life of such great holiness and witness to Christ. I truly feel humbled to know that he was my brother, and he is now with God in heaven. He has been a great inspiration to me, a great role model to me, and a great friend, confidant, who loved me very dearly. And I truly bless and thank God for his life, for his ministry, which touched the hearts of so many thousands of people, simple people, humble people, very much like Jesus, who went after the lost, who went after the poor, who went after the weak. Father Joseph Abraham, or Father Marai, as we would call him very lovingly, did the same. We pray that he will continue to bless us from heaven. He is a great inspiration to so many, and I'm sure that he will send us plentiful graces from heaven, and he's going to be even closer to us than he was here on earth. And I continue to draw great strength from even his funeral, where so many people came to bear witness to his love. May God be praised. Thank you.